Hello everyone, I'm Dante from Low Manor, and welcome to another Lore Watch. Today we're looking at the newest addition to Overwatch, the elusive hacker, Sombra. With the Omnic Crisis ravaging the world some 30 years ago, children born around that time were amongst the most damaged by the war. All lost someone. Most lost family, most lost everything. The girl who would eventually become the woman we know as Sombra fell into the last group. While all countries suffered, Mexico was hit particularly hard by the crisis, with their cities, their power lines, and even their people left devastated. The girl lost her parents, but she was hardly unique in this, and her homeland did not have the resources available to support her and any of her contemporaries. What separated her out from her fellow orphans, however, was a prodigious ability with technology, specifically its security or lack thereof. Even at an early age, she could do things with computers that people with far more experience could not, and she utilized these skills to survive in a world that otherwise would have crushed her. The girl was by no means entirely a victim of circumstance, however. It did not take long at all for her to realize that the secrets and schemes presented to her through her hacking enabled her to control and manipulate people, just as reliably as she did machines. She was ruthless in her use of these talents, not caring who it impacted as long as it helped her, and she had fun while doing it. In order to make use of her abilities, both on the move and without bringing herself to the attention of the authority figures, she styled and built a portable kit that allowed her to access, compromise, and display any data she desired, fashioned into a backpack and glove. These skills brought her to the attention of the Mexican Los Muertos gang, self-styled revolutionaries, but in reality, a lawless and thoroughly criminal group. Under the Los Muertos banner, she began to take up their own ideological goals. Although, from what we know of her character, it seems likely that there were purely selfish motivations in play as well. Los Muertos have always stated their beliefs that the rebuilding process Mexico underwent following the crisis was corrupt, benefiting only the rich and powerful at the expense of its citizens. To them, the epitome of this was Guillermo Portero, president of Mexico following the crisis, and now CEO of Lumerico, a company tasked with bringing the country back into prosperity through a nationwide system of interconnected, clean nuclear fusion plants. Referred to as the King Viper by his enemies, Portero nevertheless forged on with his dream of making his homeland the envy of the world, though the lengths he would go to make this a reality were shrouded in mystery and innuendo. In the girl, Los Muertos believed they had the perfect tool to unlock all of Portero's secrets, and she set about accessing every nook and cranny of Lumerico's systems. At some point, she dug too deep, and for the first time in her life, she was discovered by something she could not control, disable, or manipulate. Her incursions into Lumerico had brought her to the attention of something larger, more secretive, and substantially more powerful than anything she had ever encountered before. A true global conspiracy. One that Lumerico was seemingly a part of. Whoever they were, their abilities and influence far exceeded anything the girl had ever encountered before, and her identity was irrevocably compromised. Rather than give in and surrender, the girl did what she had always done. She fought to survive. Purging all trace of the girl she had been from every record and every computer across the world, she went underground. Recognizing the fact that her current abilities and equipment would pose no chance of uncovering the truth, she underwent extensive upgrades. Gone was the backpack she had used all her life, and in its place, countless cybernetic upgrades were grafted onto her. Most notable of all of these was the intracranial implants, effectively turning her own brain into one of the sleekest and most efficient hacking tools in the world. Combined with improved combat skills, altered technology pilfered from former Overwatch agents, and advanced thermoptic camouflage, the woman that emerged was no longer the girl. Sombra was born. With her new abilities established, Sombra reappeared, fueled by both a desire for the truth and the power that would come from knowing it. She launched a series of attacks more audacious than any she had attempted in her previous life. Whatever the visible intention of these was to the world, for Sombra, everything she did now was in order to move closer to uncovering the conspiracy. It is almost certain that she was investigating the very same machinations that have obsessed Jack Morrison in recent years. But while he is motivated by revenge and justice, Sombra is far more egotistical than that. True to form, these hacks brought her to the attention of one of the few organizations in the world that could provide her with that kind of power, Talon. Bolstered by the fall of Overwatch and the increasing lawlessness of the world, Talon had grown in scale and scope in the following years. Sombra, to them, was a perfect fit. For her, they were powerful allies with useful connections, and seemingly limitless funds that she could manipulate to her own ends. Understandably, much of her work is done in secret, hidden in the same shadow that cloaks Talon. She is their first port of call when needing to break into or decrypt data, and whenever their unique brand of chaos cannot be enforced through boots on the ground, shotgun shells, or a bullet from a sniper rifle. To this end, she was once again brought around to Lumerico, the company that in the intervening years had almost finished construction of their chain of interconnected reactors across Mexico. She waged a campaign against them, once again focusing on Portero as she had done in years before. Only this time, she invoked the name of Los Muertos and engaged the population to rise up and assist her against this systematic corruption. Whether this publicity shielded her from harm, or whether the hidden power simply had no further need to protect Portero, we may never know, but the campaign was a success. Shamed by scandal, Portero was forced to step down, the King Viper dethroned in acrimony. With their leader gone, their network compromised and public opinion against them, Lumerico itself could soon meet a similar end. More recently, Talon have turned their attentions toward the second Omnic crisis raging in Russia, in particular the great defender and hero of the Russian people, Katya Volskaya, CEO of Volskaya Industries, architects of the giant Svirgator mechs that to this day are a symbol of Russia's ingenuity, power, and independence. Much as they had with Takata Mondatta, Talon's goal was to plunge the era into chaos with her assassination, and to that end, Sombra, along with Reaper and Widowmaker, were dispatched. Unbeknownst to her comrades, Sombra had other plans, triggering the alarm to delay them and send Katya into lockdown. Her goal was to leverage extremely volatile information against Volskaya in order to make use of her power and influence later down the line. Knowing Russia to be one of the most anti-Omnic nations on Earth, their resurgent post-crisis built on a sense of pride and innovation as the only country in the world to stand alone against the Omnics and win, Katya knew how devastating the knowledge that their tech all came from Omnic sources would be, and was prepared to agree anything to keep it hidden. Sombra is nothing if not thorough, however. Her implied threat to Katya's daughter left hanging in the air as she made her escape. With her intentions firmly on uncovering the global conspiracy, and robbing it of all knowledge, power, and influence for her own use, Talon may in the long run not prove to be as gullible as Sombra believes. To her though, everything is hackable, everyone is open to manipulation, and someday she will be the one pulling the strings. Thanks for watching this episode of Lore Watch. With Sombra interrupting our schedule somewhat, we're now back on track and we'll be bringing you Bastion's Lore Watch soon. If you enjoyed this vid, then please hit that like button and sub if you want to see more. You can check out our previous Lore Watch and another video right here. Until next time, I've been Dantir, thanks for watching.